this raising of capital it can be like this. Who all will contribute to this capital? Promoters will contribute. And then one more person called as, sorry, I'll write it this way, reserved category persons. Reserved category persons, they will contribute. And then the outside public will contribute. This outside public contribution, henceforth we will call by a term called as net offer to public. See, who will contribute towards the capital? Promoter should contribute. We know what should be the promoter's contribution. The promoter's contribution of 20% is the minimum contribution, or is it the maximum contribution? Minimum contribution, which is given there. Ipo, apart from promoters, who are all the other persons if you take? Outside public will contribute. This outside public is called as net offer to the public. And then we have got one more category of persons called as reserved category. Some reservations are made for certain category of persons who can contribute to the capital of the company. Are you all following? Sorry. Now, how much should be the net offer to the public? That is going to be our next discussion. Net offer to the public, how much it can be? Now, we should link this with securities contract regulation rules. SCRR na enna? Securities contract regulation rules. See, the securities contract regulation rules say, if the post issue capital, if the post issue capital calculated at the issue price, the post issue capital which is calculated at the issue price is lesser than rupees 4000 crores. If the post issue capital calculated at issue price, if it is going to be lesser than 4000 crores, the public should hold at least 25%. At least 25% of the shares shall be made available to the public. Let me repeat this. Where if the post issue capital, we are going to issue some capital. Post issue capital, after issuing this capital, what will be the total number of shares in the company? Take the total number of shares, multiply it by the issue price. If the resultant figure is going to be lesser than 4000 crores, then public should hold at least 25% shares. Abdina enna artham? We should offer at least 25% shares to the public. Are you all following? If this post issue capital if it is going to be greater than 4000 crores, If it is going to be greater than 4000 crores, then the public should hold at least 10%. I will tell you the logic for this, not for 25%, 10%. I will tell you why should the securities contract regulation rules compel you to do this. Let me give you a small illustration, sir. Copied this. Do you need any assistance in what I have written here? Which one, madam? 10%. Public contribution must be at least 10%. Are you all with me? I will give you a scenario. Myself, my wife, children, wife, sister, then her husband, all these persons, 8 to 10 persons, we are holding shares in a company. We are holding, I am happy, no, from that itself you should know, sir. We are all holding some 4 crore shares in a company. Who are the other shareholders? Now, there is no other shareholders. Only ourselves and our family members are the shareholders. What is the total number of shares? Na? 4 crore shares into 10 rupees per share, 40 crores. Suddenly, we want some additional capital. When we want some additional capital, we are not having funds in hands. We decide to go for a public issue. How many shares we are going for public issue? Na? 1 lakh shares we are going for public issue. How many shares? 1 lakh. Which means now only 1 lakh shares will be made available to the public. See, out of 4 crore shares, if only 1 lakh shares are made available to the public through this public issue, the trading in the shares becomes very, very difficult. There will be, what to say, there will be no market for easy liquidity of these shares. Yes or not? Only when there are more outside persons, only when the more public is holding, some will be intending to sell the shares, some will be intending to buy the shares. Here, out of 4 crore shares, 1 lakh shares alone is held by the public. Means, now these 4 crore shares we are not going to sell. Enna sir? Appo, the trading itself should take place only within this small circle of 1 lakh. Means, the person who is putting money, he will not be having a ready market to sell the shares. Yes or not? Adanala securities contract regulation rules, what it is saying, minimum 25% of the capital should be made available to the public if you want to go for a public issue. Yes, sir. Or else you yourself manage, get loan, give preference shares, give debentures to known persons, you yourself manage. When you are going for a public issue, at least 25% of the overall capital should be made available to the public. Only then they can trade in the stock exchange and they can have easy, viable market in the stock exchange. Are you all following? Anna, what he is saying is giving some relaxations. Where the capital which is computed as per the present issue price, if it is going to be more than 4000 crores, if that is going to be more than 4000 crores, you can go for a public issue. If it is even 10%, it is sufficient. I don't know whether you were in the news or not, or you were hearing the news or not. This regulation came into effect on 1st June 2010. And a period of 3 years were given to all the existing companies to increase their public shareholding to 25%. How they can increase the public shareholding to 25%? Either they can issue new shares or they can compel their promoters to give their shares. Reduction now only by transfer to outsiders it is possible. When 1st June or July 2013 came, these persons, some of the companies didn't comply with that provision, and then SEBI passed an order over 108 companies 108 companies did not comply with this provision stating that 25% share should be held by the public. So a transitionary time of 3 years was given. 108 companies did not comply with that. SEBI passed an order against all these companies. Some of the company shareholders, what they did, some of the company directors, what they did, they went for delisting. Because I am holding 85% shares in the company, my great-great-grandfather started the company, came to my grandfather like this, family base I am running this company. Are you all with me? So some of them, what they did, the promoters itself tried to purchase the shares and then delisted the shares. Are you all with me? Others and all faced some consequences for not complying with this provision. Concept purinjada sir? So whenever you are going to issue shares to the public, what you should do? At least 25% of the shares should be made available to the public. Are you all following? At least 25% should be made available to the public. Can I?
Yes, sir.
Right. Now, in the reserved category, people are there. Reserved category people, there are some reservations. Emmanuel, AC pada solupa, the AC. Now, friends, listen. Reserved category people, what is the reservations which are there? Listen. These persons are the reserved category people. Sir, please listen here. For all the reserved category people, number one, employees. Number two, shareholders. Number three, persons who are associated with the issuer. Again, listen here. All these things are nothing but a motivation to some category of people. Suppose the entire share, sir, very simple. Entire shares, if I am going to issue to the public and the promoters alone means, then business carrying on becomes difficult. Now what the law is contemplating, it is saying that certain persons shares should be reserved. For certain persons, shares should be reserved. For example, an employee. He will be waiting for the company to allot sweat equity shares. Company might not be allotting sweat equity shares. When the company is coming for a public issue, now through this public issue, he may want to purchase the share, yes or not? But when he is participating or when he is competing among with the entire public at large, the probability that he may get share is very difficult, or the probability is that he will get very less share, correct? Adanala, a reservation is given to the employees. How much is that? Not exceeding 5% of the post issue capital. Minimum is there. Maximum. Maximum, how much you can reserve for your own employees? Not exceeding 5% of the post issue capital. You highlight it, na? Employee means who I will read. Come to the previous page. Come to the previous page. Employees, in the case of normally employees, and in the case of new issuer, persons who are in the permanent and full-time employment of the promoting companies, excluding the promoters and an immediate relative of the promoter of such company. Listen, this is the first time I am going in for a public issue. How much should be reserved? How much can be maximum reserved for the employees? Maximum 5%. Ye employees na yaar na? My employee, my promoter company employee. Are you all with me? Employees And in case of new issuer, if it is going to be a new issuer like me, persons who are in the permanent and full-time employment of the promoting company. Are you all following? I am the company in question. Sir, we all know one company can promote another company, correct? Bharti Airtel Limited is there. It promoted a company called as Bharti Infratel Limited. Main duty of Bharti Infratel Limited is that everywhere towers are there, no? Many of those towers are owned by Bharti Infratel Limited, wherein Bharti Airtel Limited, it will render service to Vodafone, to Aircel, Airtel, to all the persons it will be rendering service, and it will be receiving income from them. In the company, who is the promoter? Now, Bharti Airtel Limited is the promoter of this company. Are you all with me? Ipo, when Bharti Infratel is going for a public issue, if Bharti Infratel is going for a public issue, what it can do? For its employees, it can allot maximum 5%. And within this 5%, his employees and his promoter employees should also be included. Following a compulsion illa, optional. For your employees and for your promoter company employees also, you can accommodate. Are you all with me? Next. Then, that I am going to say, where there is a reserved category, there is a shortfall in the reserved category, means it can be adjusted with the other reserved category. That is possible. Sir, is working, are you all comfortable? Sir, now what is that we have discussed today? Public issue, how the company will get money, three mechanisms are there. What are all the three mechanisms? One is the promoter contribution, the other is the contribution by the reserved category people, the third one is the contribution by the public. Inime, we will not call it as public, we will call it by a distinct name called as net offer to the public. Sorry, how much should be the net offer to public? How much should be the net offer to the public? It is not given under SEBI regulation. SEBI regulation is making a reference to securities contract regulation rules. Securities contract regulation rules, enna solradhana, the net offer to the public shall be 25%. Are you all with me? Or it can even be 10% depending upon the capital issue, that is on the present price at which you issued multiplied by the overall number of shares of the company. If this is going to be greater than 4000 crores, 10% possible. In other cases, 25% is possible. Purunjitha? Sari. Ipo is a net offer to the public category. Next, we are going to discuss about reservations. Reserved category. Reserved category, la, three persons will be regarded as reserved category in the case of a book building issue. For all the three persons who will be considered as reserved category members, na, employees. Employees, na, my employees, my promoting company employees. Puriyadha, sir. Next one is the shareholders. Shareholder, na, which shareholder? My shareholder, my promoting company shareholder. Are you all with me? As the next. Shareholders means shareholders of the listed promoting companies in case of a new issuer, and the listed group companies in the case of an existing issuer. Apo he is defining everything very wide here. Following us. Next. Certain persons will be associated with the with these persons in the book building process. Book building process is more complicated rather than a normal public issue process. Yes or not? Enaya, book building la, you should get the bids. All these lengthy processes are there, no? Now what is saying? These persons who help you in the public issue process, for them also you should make some reservation. Persons who, as on the date of filing the draft offer document with the board, are associated with the issuer as depositors, bondholders or subscribers to the services of the issuer making an initial public offer. However, the issuer shall not make reservation to the issue management team, syndicate members, their promoters, directors and employee, and for the group or associate companies of the issue management team and the syndicate members and their promoters, directors and employees. So, This is wide enough to include even my creditors, debtors, my service providers, ellariyum setukuren. Are you all with me? So these three persons ku I am giving a benefit. How I can give a benefit? How I can give a benefit? I can give a benefit stating that to my employees maximum 5% of the post issue capital, to the other person 10% of the maximum post issue capital, sorry 10% of the issue size, to this person 5% of the issue price. Like this I can fix the maximum ceiling. Purinjada? If it is going to be a fixed price issue, not a book built issue, if it is going to be a fixed price issue, the last category person will not come. The last category person will not come. If it is going to be a fixed price issue, means the reservations can be made only for employees as well as to the shareholders. Now next issue. Sir, my employees are there. Can my employees make use of this reserved category, and then can he also come through the public route also? For example, 10 lakh shares I am offering. How many shares? 10 lakh shares. In the provision body, maximum how much I can allot to my employees? 10 lakh la 5%. That is the maximum thing which I can allot to my employees, which means up to 50,000 shares I can allot to my employees. Correct? My employees, they are making application for 50,000 shares under this specific reservation category, and through open counter also, through net offer to the public also, they are making some more applications. Possible or not possible? So that is what we are going to see here. The aforementioned persons, except an employee and retail individual investor, shall not make an application in the net offer to public category. Abdinal enna, an employee, retail individual investor, they can still make an application through the net offer to the public category. Sir, purinjada? This is like this, sir. Once if a person falls under specific reservation, he should not claim the benefits under general reservation. Abdinu he is trying to communicate. However, there also relaxation is given to the employees and retail individual shareholder. Large scale individual shareholder, can he again come to the open market route? Na? That is not possible. How they will find out? Na? Normally using PAN numbers they track out. You all following? Everybody, enga reserved category persons la, if it is going to be book built issue, 3% will come. Non book built issue, 2% will come. Yaar yaar la varuva? Employees. Employees na enna? Employees of the issuing company and also the employees of the promoting company. இவனுக்கு எவ்வளோ? மேக்சிமம் 5% ஆஃப் போஸ்ட் இஷ்யூ கேபிட்டல். இஃப் ஐ புட் பிஐசி போஸ்ட் இஷ்யூ கேபிட்டல். நெக்ஸ்ட், வேர் ஷேர் ஹோல்டர்ஸ் ஆர் தேர், இந்த ஷேர் ஹோல்டர்ஸ்ல shareholders of issuing company, normally the shareholders of the issuing company, they will be the promoters themselves. And this is the first time they are going in for a public issue, so normally here the shareholders will be promoters themselves. Apparam shareholders of promoting company, shareholders of promoting companies, group companies. Abdinna, look at the wide perspective. If Bharti Airtel is promoting Bharti Infratel Limited, and later when Bharti Infratel Limited is going for a further issue, what can be done? Reservation can be made for the shareholders of Bharti Infratel Limited, Bharti Airtel Limited, and any other subsidiaries or associates of Bharti Airtel Limited. சரி, இங்க எவ்வளோ? மேக்சிமம் 10% ஆஃப் தி இஷ்யூ கேபிட்டல். Next, persons connected with the issuer. Persons connected with the issuer. A maximum 5% of the issued capital. Important note, employees and retail individual shareholders can apply under open category system also, that is under net offer to public system also. I am having 5 crores capital. I am issuing another 5 crores capital. Appa issue size ingirathu, this is 5 crores. Issued capital na the capital which I am issuing now. Idu inda 5 crores. Post issue na 5 plus 5, 10 crores. Adhula I should apply. Correct. Mela polama. Can we proceed further? Sorry. Suppose, listen. Here I am allotting something to the employees, or I am saying that employees can get maximum 3%. I am saying law is putting only a maximum limit of 5%. Here I am saying employees 3%, shareholders 6%, and persons connected with the issuer 2%. I am saying, are you all with me? No takers in persons connected with the issuer. What should be done? There are no takers in this person connected with the issuer category. Purunjada sir? Whereas in employees category, all the employees they are applying, it is exceeding this 3% limit itself. Getting my point or not? Now what can be done? That is the next thing which we are going to discuss. Any unsubscribed portion in any reserved category may be added to any other reserved category, and the unsubscribed portion, if any, after such inter-se adjustments among the reserved category, shall be added to the net offer to the public category. So here 3%, 6%, 2%, I am saying 2% of the persons connected with the issue here, if they are not taking, I can give it to the employees. Employees also, I am not able to use this 2%. Now I can use it for net offer to the public category. It is young, you will find usage for this. No, where the issue is getting oversubscribed, you will face all these problems. Public law also, they are contributing, they are applying more. Employees also, they are applying more. Now what you will do in the persons connected with the issuer category, they are not applying. Now I will take this and I will use it for employees category. Angi, if I am not able to use this na, then I will use it for open category. Puriyadha? Everyone. Next. This is a specific reservation. Next, under open quota, there is a reservation. Under open quota, there is a reservation. What is the reservation in net offer to public category? Reservation in net offer to public category. In what is the reservation in this net offer to the public category? Listen. Are you all following? In the reservation in this net offer to public category, do you remember we have in initial public offer, I am having scheme 1, scheme 2. Scheme 1 light is 50% of QIB, scheme 2 light is 75% of the QIB, we discussed, yes or not? Appo, in reservation in the net offer to the public category, if you are falling under scheme 1 or if you are falling under scheme 2, scheme 1 na satisfy all the 5 conditions. Satisfy all the 5 conditions which are given in regulation 26 bracket 1. In and all 5 conditions, net tangible assets greater than or equal to 3 crores, net profits or this divisible profits are greater than or equal to 15 crores, net worth greater than or equal to 1 crore. Similarly, the proposed issue plus previous issue in the same financial year, it shall be lesser than or equal to 5 times of the pre-issue net worth. Income from name change 50%, the criteria are clear. If I satisfy these criteria, then a specific reservation under the open reservation category. Net offer to the public, there is a reservation. Next, scheme 2 in 75%. Now you yourself can say, what is the reservation in this, reservation in this, you yourself can say. Here also it is classified into 3. One is to the qualified institutional buyers, the other is the non-institutional buyer, the other is the retail individual investor. The qualified institutional buyer, I should start with this here. In the qualified institutional buyer, maximum how much I can allot na? 50%. Come on, friends. See, are you all getting the structure or not? Structure is sir. 100% capital I should get, correct? And the 100% capital, how I can tap? Sure to sure, promoter should contribute, correct? Up minimum 20% should come from promoter side. Next, balance 80% is open, maximum that is. Maximum balance 80% is open, that I can get from the net offer to public, from the open public, net offer to the public category lane I can get, reserved category lane I can get. Correct? Now, reserved category ki internal we are placing a ceiling. What is the internal ceiling which we are placing to the reserved category? Employees, shareholders, persons connected to the issuer, these persons will come under the reserved category, they can make contributions, correct? Yes, sir. Similarly, the next category is open offer category, net offer to the public category. And the net offer to the public category, internally I am placing some other reservations. Following? So what should be that reservation? If I am complying with all those 5 conditions, 50% QIB, we told, correct? So here how much should be allotted to QIB, say 50%. Adula ulla unno reservation. Reservation is that when you are allotting this to QIBs, minimum 5% should be done to mutual funds. Minimum 5% should be done to mutual funds. I told QIB is a very big block which consists of mutual funds, alternate investment funds, collective investment scheme, pension fund, provident fund, trust, like this many persons are there in QIB. I told maximum 50% you can allot to QIBs, and out of this 50%, 15% should be allotted to mutual funds. Ademari anchor investor up to 30% it should be allotted. Who is anchor investor? I told you. Anchor investor na a person who is applying, he is a QIB who is applying for shares the value of which is greater than 10 crores. If any person is making an application for shares, that is a QIB is making application for shares which is greater than 10 crores, na, you call it as an anchor investor. So anchor investor, he is a QIB whose share application is greater than rupees 10 crores. Are you all with me? Structure purinjada sir? Ippo in the book building process la, normal book building mechanism means maximum 50% I should allot to QIBs, the balance 35% I allot to retail individual investor and the other to non-institutional investor. This is the proportion. If it is going to be the other category of thing, scheme 2 agardal, this 50% la add 25%, here reduce 25%. Avladan. Here you add 25%, retail individual investor kita you reduce this 25%. Logic is this, sir. 50% QIB ki who can go? Company which is having a net worth of 3 crore rupees, company which is having a profit of 15 crores. Like this, if you look at this 50% QAB, company will be a good company, having a good track record. Adanala, I am allowing more individual investor to contribute that. Whereas, if you are not complying with this, any of these 5 conditions, the company is not that much a good company, thereby I am passing the risk to the QABs for them to contribute 75%, reducing it from the retail individual investors portfolio. So appo, this is the thing. Idella in the, if we are going for initial public offer. Are you all following? Correct. அதாவது at least 25% சொல்றோம் இல்லையா, அந்த நெட் ஆஃபர் டு தி பப்ளிக் ஹவு மச் யூ ஆர் மேக்கிங், பிகாஸ் எல்ஸ் இட் பிகம் ரிடிகுலஸ். இங்கே 100% வந்துடுறது வாட் அதனால தான் சொன்னேன், திஸ் இஸ் அன் இன்டர்னல் ரிசர்வேஷன், திஸ் இஸ் அன் இன்டர்னல் ரிசர்வேஷன். ஆர் யூ ஆல் கெட்டிங் மீ? என்ன சார்? சரி, இப்போ ஆல் தி ஸ்டோரிஸ் வில் அப்ளை. இந்த 50%, 75%, ஸ்கீம் 1, ஸ்கீம் 2, இதெல்லாம் வில் அப்ளை இன் தி கேஸ் ஆஃப் அ புக் பில்டிங் ப்ராசஸ். வென் ஐ ஃபிக்ஸ்டு தி ப்ரைஸ் த்ரூ புக் பில்டிங் ப்ராசஸ், ஆல் தி ஸ்டோரிஸ் வில் அப்ளை. இஃப் ஐ எம் கோயிங் ஃபார் அ ஃபிக்ஸ்டு ப்ரைஸ் இஷ்யூ, தட் இஸ் நான் புக் பில்டிங் ப்ராசஸ்னா ஹவு டு அலோகேட். அலாட்மெண்ட் இஸ் லைக் திஸ், அதர்வைஸ் தேன் புக் பில்டிங் ப்ராசஸ்னா அலோகேஷன் இன் தி நெட் ஆஃபர் டு தி பப்ளிக் ஷால் பி, retail individual investor will be 50%, non retail individual investor, body corporates etc will be the balance. This also appears to be logical. Why? Because when you are going in book building process, who will be the predominant bidder? Abadina only the QIBs. Book building process la we should go through a bidding process, no sir? Adala maina who will be participating in this bidding na QIBs. அதனால்தான் இஃப் யூ ஆர் கோயிங் ஃபார் புக் பில்டிங் ப்ராசஸ் ஐ எம் கிவிங் மோர் ப்ரிஃபரன்ஸ் டு QIBs, எல்ஸ் புக் பில்டிங் ப்ராசஸ் இட் செல்ஃப் வில் ஃபெயில். அண்ட் இண்டிவிஜுவல் இன்வெஸ்டர் வில் நாட் பி இன்ட்ரெஸ்டட் இன் பார்ட்டிசிபேட்டிங் இன் தி பில்டிங். ஸோ அதனால வென் ஐ எம் கோயிங் ஃபார் அ புக் பில்டிங் ப்ராசஸ் மோர் ப்ரிஃபரன்ஸ் இஸ் கிவன் டு QIBs, whereas இன் அதர் கேசஸ் மோர் ப்ரிஃபரன்ஸ் இஸ் கிவன் டு தி ரீட்டைல் இண்டிவிஜுவல் இன்வெஸ்டர். ஆர் யூ ஆல் கெட்டிங் மீ? Everybody, ஒரு தடவை கன்சாலிடேட் பண்ணிடலாமா? வேர் டு பி ஸ்டாண்ட்? ஃபர்ஸ்ட் வி டிஸ்கஸ், இஃப் ஐ எம் கோயிங் டு மேக் அ பப்ளிக் இஷ்யூ, வாட் ஆர் ஆல் தி கண்டிஷன்ஸ் டு பி சாட்டிஸ்ஃபைட், எலிஜிபிலிட்டி கண்டிஷன்ஸ் என்ன, தென் மேக் அ டிராஃப்ட் ஆஃபர் டாக்குமெண்ட், வாட் இஸ் ஃபாஸ்ட் ட்ராக் இஷ்யூ, வாட் ஆர் ஆல் தி அதர் கண்டிஷன்ஸ், வி டிஸ்கஸ் தி ஹெல் லாட் ஆஃப் ப்ரொசீஜர். தென் வி டிஸ்கஸ் In the case of initial public offer, what I should do? In the case of initial public offer, I am having two schemes, scheme 1, scheme 2. Scheme 1 is complying with 5 conditions. Scheme 2 is complying with 2 conditions. Book building la pono, 75% should be qualified institutional buyer. Is working, are you all getting clarity? Yeah? Next, when I am going for a further public offer, same like the earlier one, but in a scheme 1, the last 2 conditions alone, I should satisfy. Inge vandena, here what should be done? The same conditions have to be satisfied. Are you all getting me? Sorry. Next, we discussed about pricing mechanism. Higher price can be fixed, lower price can be fixed. Specific for some category, price can be fixed differently. We discussed that. Next, we discussed what is the promoter's contribution. How much should be the promoter's contribution? Minimum how much, maximum how much? All these stories we discussed. Then we discussed what is the lock-in period of promoter. Now we are coming to the next big phase where we are discussing that what should be done in the case of an reservations and allotment. Promoter pati we have discussed, no sir. In may balance only 2 other category of persons are there. Who are all the other 2 category of persons? Reserved category persons, net offer to the public. Net offer to the public la minimum 25% in some cases, minimum 10% in some cases. Correct? Apo promoter's contribution ko minimum evalone I have specified. Net offer to the public liyo minimum evalone I have specified. Yes or not? Apo promoter's contribution cannot go beyond 75%. Net offer category cannot go beyond 80%. Correct? So in between this range, only allotment should be done. Correct? Now what I am doing in the net offer to the public category, internal reservations I am providing. What are all the internal reservations? How much I can allot to retail individual investor? How much I can allot to non-institutional investor? How much I can allot to qualified institutional buyer? Internal ceiling I am providing. And the internal ceiling is 35 for RII, 15 for NII and 50% for QIB. Either if I am satisfying with scheme 1. Scheme 1 is there. Next, scheme 2. If I am going to go for scheme 2, na QIB ke evlo sir appointment allot panna scheme 2 la? 75% to QIB. Participate panna da sir, it will go into mine. QIB ke how much I will allot? 75%. Okay. Ipo scheme 1 risky or scheme 2 risky? Scheme 2 is risky. In a scheme 1 la, very quality conditions I have given in scheme 1. Correct? Appa scheme 2 is risky. Scheme 2 risky na, where I should reduce? Individual investor, retail individual investor, persons who are contributing in small scale, I should protect them. Qualified institutional buyer means it can bear the loss, sir. Small scale investors, they cannot bear the loss. Correct? Adanala what I am doing there? There I am reducing them to 10%. Qualified institutional buyer, I am making it as 25%. Non-institutional investor the stand at 15% and 15%. Puriyada? Correct. Scheme 2 always through book building process. Scheme 1 can be through book building process or it can be through non-book building process. Ipo, if it is going to be scheme 1 made through book building process, nechukonga. Appo this rule. If it is going to be through non-book building process, appo this 50-50 will come. Book building is different, fixed price issue is different. Abadi paatha inda third category varave mudiyadu. Adavadhu anga 5 condition paathom illaya, and 5 condition la engiyume book building pathiye we didn't speak. There we saw 5 conditions, we never spoke about book building. And the second condition pathi when we spoke about book building and QIB. Another that will sustain. 5 conditions plus book building means this will sustain 50. Correct. Without that means without book building, fixed price issue means this will come. Sorry. Next. Next. I'll discuss the safety net and green shoe. Safety net arrangement and green shoe option. Abdin rendu concepts are there. I will discuss that Your mind is agile, it can absorb things. What, Shiva? Now, please know. அப்படி சொல்றீங்கம்மா, ரெண்டு மினிமம் தானே சொல்றோம், கிடையாது ப்ரொமோட்டரும் மினிமம். அச்சுச்சோ, 20% ஃபார் ப்ரொமோட்டர் கான்ட்ரிபியூஷன் மினிமம். இங்கே 25% இன் நெட் ஆஃபர் டு தி பப்ளிக் இஸ் மினிமம். பேலன்ஸ் ஹவுஸ் ஓவர் யூ வாண்ட் யூ கேன் பிளே. ப்ரொமோட்டர் கான்ட்ரிபியூஷன் ஐ கேன் ஹேவ் 50, நெட் ஆஃபர் டு தி பப்ளிக் ஐ கேன் ஹேவ் 50. Reserved category, I need not have anything. You know, reserved category does not speak about minimum. Reserved category speaks only about maximum. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Okay. I will discuss about this safety net arrangement. First, let me read that safety net arrangement. Tell me whether we can proceed as it is. The object of safety net arrangement is to protect the individual investors who subscribed to the shares at a high price, but subsequently the price of the securities fall down after listing of the securities. It means an arrangement which is provided by the issuer, under which a person offers to purchase specified securities from the original resident retail individual allottees at the issue price. Any such arrangement shall provide for an offer to purchase up to a maximum of 1000 specified securities per original resident retail individual allottee at the issue price within a period of 6 months from the last date of dispatch of security certificates or credit of demat account. Understood? First point to be understood, safety net arrangement is optional. Safety net arrangement is optional. Green shoe option is also optional. Now, what is the object of this safety net arrangement? Right. I will ask you a simple question, sir. You have seen circus, sir? In circus, they will be playing this trapezium, correct? When they are playing that, they will tie a net, correct? Why they are trying the net? Suppose when they fall down, net will save them and they will again climb back and they will be normal, correct? The same thing can happen even in the case of shares. Normally what happens, when the companies they are going in for a public issue, that too particularly this fixed price issue, book build issue, at least you can have a sense or a smell, you can smell what is the real intention which is going in the mind of the investors, correct? If it is going to be a fixed price issue, sometimes the company may fix the shares at a higher price. But after the shares are allotted and the shares goes for a listing, and when the shares go for a listing, the moment it is listed, in another 2 or 3 days, the share price will fall down very steeply. Who will be affected? Shareholders will be affected. Now, in the safety net mechanism, what it is doing? It is falling down now. It should be brought back to normalcy. The safety net arrangement, what will happen? A person will be appointed by the company. There will be a contract between the company and the person. What this person will do is, when the price of the share is coming down, he will purchase the share. From whom? From the resident individual investor. How much share he will purchase from them? The shares which they have actually subscribed are 1000 shares, whichever is less. At what price he will purchase? He will not purchase at the present market price, he will purchase at the issue price. Suppose I am a resident individual investor holding some 500 shares in a company. I purchased it for 200 per share. How much per share? 200. Listing bond on this 200 came to 120 rupees. I will normally sit in a corner and cry, correct? Yes or not? So now what happens? In the safety net mechanism, now I can go to that particular person and I can say, give me back 500 into 200 rupees, you give me back, I will get that amount back from him and I will give the shares to him. Thereby, I am saved. I got my 1 lakh rupees back. Anna, this is a provision which is generally made only to a resident individual retail investor, because institutional investor means he can appoint an expert, he can use the services of an expert to find out whether you can invest in the shares of this company or you cannot invest in the shares of this company, yes or not? As an individual investor, I am not having all those abilities. In the protection, they want to give only to a resident investor. Follow him. This is what we mean by safety net arrangement. Aduvum, when he is purchasing too many shares, that should not be allowed. 1,000 shares only this benefit is available. Regulation 44 says only for 1,000 shares this benefit is available. Purunjitha sir? Everyone. Right. I'll read this illustration. ABC Limited makes a public issue of securities, and these securities are priced at rupees 750 per share. Let us assume that the company has made safety net arrangements by entering into a contract with a financially sound third party XYZ and Co. Mr. X subscribed for 500 shares and he was allotted 500 shares. Subsequently, after listing of the securities, the market price fell to rupees 450 per share. Now Mr. X can sell his 500 shares to that financially sound third party XYZ and Co. at a price of 750 per share. And he remains unaffected by the market fluctuations. Inge innonu gavanikkanum. Company cannot purchase the share because section 77 says purchase of own shares is prohibited. Are you all with me? Abba, who can purchase only a financially sound third party will purchase. Normally, when a fellow like this person will come forward, only when he is so confident that share price will not come down and share price will go up, only when he is confident he will come forward. That is why generally in India you don't find this safety net arrangement that much, because it is not made compulsory. Also, you don't find safety net arrangement that much in India when people they go for a public issue. Are you all following us? I cannot say like that, because he is an expert who will analyze about the company, who will do a market analysis, a transactional analysis, he can do all those things. As an investor, I am guided more about the hearsay which I get from the others. So we cannot place both these persons on same footing.
So I don't
want to take that. Correct. Can I proceed? Next we are having one more concept called as green shoe option. Why this name green shoe option? Green shoe option. Why it is named as green shoe option? When they are performing this, what they will do? Green color shoe they should wear. Correct? Alla oru karmam illa. This mechanism was first done in the public issue of a company called as Green Shoe Limited. Green Shoe Limited, there is a company, not in India, this mechanism got its birth outside India only. In the Green Shoe Company, this Green Shoe Company came out with this mechanism. So, thereby they named it as a Green Shoe Option. And green color shoe ku idukum oru sambandhamum kedaiyadhu. Take this illustration. Sir, closely follow this illustration. Wipro Limited is there. It is going to issue 1 lakh equity shares. What is the price? The price is rupees 750 per share. Now a resolution will be passed. resolution will be passed not for allotting 1 lakh shares but for allotting 1.15 lakhs. For what I will tell you later. For allotting 1.15 lakhs shares, a resolution will be passed. That is up to 15% of the issue capital or of the issue size, the green shoe option can be done. Following until this, right. Now, a person called as a stabilizing agent will be appointed. In the stabilizing agent, what he will do, I will tell you. Before that, tell me the rule of economics. When a product is purchased more in the market, what will happen? The price will increase. Sold now, what will happen? Price will decrease. Correct? Sorry. Now, the stabilizing agent, what he will do? Company will pass a resolution for 1.15 lakhs. And what the company will do? The company will go and issue shares only for 1 lakh. Resolution for how much it will pass? 1.15 lakhs. When it is issuing, it will issue only for 1 lakh. Purunjitha? In the stabilizing agent, what he will do? He will go and borrow shares. From whom he will go and borrow? Na? He will go and borrow shares from persons like as promoters or any person who is having greater than or equal to 5% of the share capital. Avangitendu, he will borrow the shares. Who will borrow the shares? Stabilizing it. He will borrow the shares and he will be holding the shares. He will borrow the shares and then he will be holding the shares. Are you all following? Everybody? Check. Now what happens? This, what to say? The company has received amount for how much? 1 lakh shares. Just a minute. Got it. Somebody had scolded something, I think. Listen, I said, you're fighting the thing, right? Listen. Huh? Now, stabilizing agent, he is borrowing this 15,000 shares, correct? He will borrow this 15,000 shares and he will give it to the company. To whom he will give? Company. This 15,000 shares will also issue to the public. Upon a company, 1 lakh shares it will issue to the public, plus 15,000 shares also it will issue to the public. Where this 15,000 shares came from? Borrowed shares from the promoters. Purujada? So company now it is issuing 1 lakh shares of its own, plus borrowed shares of 15,000 shares. Purujada? Right. In the 1,15,000 shares amount will be received, correct? Company will retain the amount for 1 lakh shares and 15,000 shares corresponding amount will be given to the stabilizing agent. Now, stabilizing agent will be having cash in hand to the extent of 15,000 shares. And the 15,000 shares are the promoter. Now, he will be waiting. Suppose if the price of the shares decreases, he is already having money in hand, correct? What he will do, he will go, he will use the money and then he will purchase the shares from the market. He is having money in hand, he will be purchasing shares from the market. The moment he starts to purchase shares from the market, demand increases, correct? When demand increases, what will happen? Price will also increase, correct? Now what will happen? 15,000 shares he got back. He may get 15,000 shares or he may get lesser than 15,000 shares also. First, let us assume he got 15,000 shares. At the end of the green shoe option process, he will return back this 15,000 shares to the promoter. Getting my point? Company will issue 1 lakh shares. Stabilizing agent will borrow 15,000 shares from the promoter. That will also be given to the company. That will also be issued to the company. Now, company will receive cash for 1,15,000 shares அந்த 1,15,000 ஷேர்ஸில் வாட் வில் ஹேப்பன், 1 lakh ஷேர்ஸ், சாரி தி அமௌண்ட் பர்டைனிங் டு 1 lakh ஷேர்ஸ் வில் பி ரீட்டைன்டு பை தி கம்பெனி, தி அமௌண்ட் பர்டைனிங் டு 15,000 ஷேர்ஸ் வில் பி கிவன் டு தி ஸ்டெபிலைசிங் ஏஜென்ட். Stabilizing agent, what he will be doing with this? He will remain quiet. When the price of the shares starts decreasing, stabilizing agent will go and he will start purchasing the shares. He will give the money, purchase the share. Give the money, purchase the share. Appa what will happen? This amount will come down, his share balance will increase. Correct? At the end of the period, if he has purchased the entire 15,000 shares, he can give this 15,000 shares to the promoter. Thereby, he will square off the position. Understood? சரி, நவ் வாட் மே ஹேப்பன், வென் கம்பெனி காட் திஸ் 15,000 ஷேர்ஸுக்கு அமௌண்ட்டு, இட் மே பி அட் 100 பர் ஷேர், பட் ஒன்லி வென் தி ப்ரைஸ் இஸ் ஃபாலிங் டவுன், ஸ்டெபிலைசிங் ஏஜென்ட் இஸ் கோயிங் அண்ட் பர்ச்சேசிங் தி ஷேர்ஸ். கரெக்டா? அப்போ ஸ்டெபிலைசிங் ஏஜென்ட் வுட் ஹவ் காட் 15,000 இன்டூ 100 பர் ஷேர், பட் வென் ஹி இஸ் பர்ச்சேசிங் ஹி வுட் ஹவ் பர்ச்சேஸ் அட் 15,000 அட் 95 பர் ஷேர். கரெக்டா? என்ன சார்? அப்போ ஹி வில் பி ஹேவிங் எக்ஸஸ் கேஷ் பேலன்ஸ். நோ தட் எ கேஷ் பேலன்ஸ் வில் பி யூஸ் ஃபார் ஸ்டெபிலைசிங் ஏஜென்ட்ஸ் ஃபீ அண்ட் ஈவன் ஆஃப்டர் தட் இஃப் எனி எக்ஸஸ் இஸ் தேர் இன்வெஸ்டர் எஜுகேஷன் அண்ட் ப்ரொடெக்ஷன் ஃபண்டுக்கு இட் வில் கோ. புரிஞ்சுதா? திஸ் இஸ் அ பாசிபிலிட்டி வேர் இஃப் தி ப்ரைஸ் ஆஃப் தி ஷேர்ஸ் கம்ஸ் டவுன். ப்ரைஸ் ஆஃப் தி ஷேர்ஸ் கோஸ் அப் மீன்ஸ் வாட் வில் ஹேப்பன்? Price of the share is going up means stabilizing agent need not do anything, but he will sit idle. Correct? Yes or not? But if he is sitting idle, promoter will come and kill him. Correct? So now what will happen? Company ki stabilizing agent will repay this amount. Company will allot excess 15,000 shares in the name of promoter. Are you all following? அப்போ அண்டர் திஸ் சர்க்கம்ஸ்டான்ஸ் ஒன்லி தட் ஓவர் சப்ஸ்கிரிப்ஷன் வில் கம் அண்ட் ஹெல்ப் யூ. அண்டர் திஸ் சர்க்கம்ஸ்டான்ஸ் ஒன்லி தட் ஓவர் சப்ஸ்கிரிப்ஷன் வில் கம் அண்ட் ஹெல்ப் யூ. எல்லாருக்கும் தரவா புரிஞ்சுதாப்பா? 1 lakh ஷேர்ஸ் இஸ் இஷ்யூட் பை தி கம்பெனி, 15,000 இஸ் பாரோடு ஃப்ரம் தி ப்ரொமோட்டர் அண்ட் இட் இஸ் இஷ்யூட் டு தி பப்ளிக். அமௌண்ட் இஸ் நவ் கமிங் அண்ட் சிட்டிங் இன் தி ஹேண்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் ஸ்டேபிளைசிங் ஏஜென்ட். இஃப் தி ப்ரைஸ் ஆஃப் தி ஷேர்ஸ் கம்ஸ் டவுன், I am happy, I can sell, give the amount, I can get the shares, I can give it to the promoter. But if the price is not coming up, the price is going up, Nechko. It is not coming down, it is going up. Na, the promoter will be asking back his shares, correct? Now what the company will do? That shares cannot be purchased, nothing will be done. Company will make a fresh allotment for this 15,000 shares to the promoter. For that, company needs money, no? Who will give that money? Whatever money is there in the hands of stabilizing agent, he will hand it over to the company. Am 15,000 more shares issue pannanla and the cash stabilizing agent kaiyila dhaan irukke. Share modalliye kuduthaachuma avan kaiyila irukkuradhu share illa, avan kaiyila irukkuradhu paisa. He is having money in hand. Using this money in hand, he wants to purchase the shares. Are you all getting clarity? Yeah? Okay. One more possibility is also there. He is purchasing the shares from the market. 10,000 shares only he is purchasing from the market. How many shares? 10,000 shares only he is purchasing from the market. Upon this 10,000 shares, he will hand over to the promoter. Balance 5,000 shares should be allotted in the name of promoter, no? He will give the money to the company, company will allot the balance 5,000 shares.